Toronto, baby. Hey, welcome to the channel. Sorry I haven't uploaded in a little while. I've been busy. Been playing Minecraft. And today we're going to do Jeff Buckley's Grace. Been recommending this one a lot. Directly on the comments, but also indirectly through other people I follow. They've given this really high scores, high ratings. This one got the Shrek song, right? So I'm going to try to handle this with a little bit of grace. I know this means a lot to a lot of people. I don't know a lot about it. I just know Hallelujah from trailers and things. Movies. I'm excited because I don't know what to expect. I did a little bit of research, just a tiny bit, mainly just reading the first paragraph on Wikipedia, because I know people are like, oh, you know, rip in peace, Jeff. Gone but too soon, Jeff Buckley. So I'm like, Jeff dead? How Jeff died? So rip my boy, Jeff. Let's see what he left us. I'm hoping the content itself is great. I mean, everyone knows Hallelujah. I don't know if he wrote it. I know it's been covered to hell. No, okay. So apparently it's a lot older than I thought it was. Okay, so yeah, no, he didn't write Hallelujah. I've been waffling too long. Let's just jump right into it. If you want to see the whole version of this, add any cut, check out the Patreon. I am starting a new series soon. Be on the lookout for a YouTube post or a tweet or something in the Discord about it. I think it's gonna be fun. Track one is Mojo Pin. Ooh, sweet. Those runs are great. Sorry for party rocking. Oh, that's just nice. I like the alliteration. I like that progression. Okay, we're bringing in some drums. Okay. Ooh, this is a lot more going for it than I expected. I suppose it's just sad music. The Mojo Pin. Syringe of Heroin. Okay. Ooh, a lot of information just came through. Love the voice. Oh, yeah. It's me, the Black Beauty. Ooh, okay. Do I need to get into my sads? I was just calling for here. How soulful it kind of is, like how he'll turn the end of words to kind of, I don't know, it changes. Ooh, the instrumentation is just so layered. He's doing such a good job on top of it. Yeah, I love this. What's the instrumentation at times on the drums and that guitar in particular? Kind of sounds a little Midwest emo-y at times, but it fades in and out. Black tar heroin. Well, okay. Tempo changes. Alright. What? I fucking love this, bro. Well, I don't know what to expect here. Even just from a verse to the second verse, like, it just changes. There's no clear progression here, but it's so cool. Oh, it's rips in my opinion. Back to the chorus. Oh, like... tempo changes, like... what the fuck? I got so many images there. Like I... kind of was getting images even of, like, Chris Cornell. Which, that's really, really cool, because, okay... Hallelujah, my biggest emotional connection to that song is Chester Bennington at Chris Cornell's funeral, because they were really good friends. He sung Hallelujah, and then a couple weeks later killed himself. And Chester Bennington's my number one, man. I love Chris Cornell too, but Chester, ooh. So like one of the last things you hear from him is this emotional Hallelujah, made famous by Jeff Buckley, right? It's so weird that all this is like full circle, you know? At the end of that song, that sounded a lot like a Chris Cornell project or Soundgarden or something. Like, that's... I loved how the tempo could just change and fucking die. The way his pronunciation of these words, like, god damn. This dude had something, man. That's a perfect. I can't imagine anything but a perfect there, guys. Holy crap. Holy crap, Lois! Takeaway I'm gonna have at the end of this is, damn, If only he didn't die. Things that would have came out. God damn. Already imagining him getting like a little heavier too. We'll still see if that happens on this album, but that's gonna be really cool. I didn't expect this to be as upbeat as it is too. Like, expecting a lot of piano ballads. Okay. Lyrically, I'm getting like Radiohead a little bit, which is cool. Ah! Ooh. Now we're back bright and happy. Like, that was very, like, harsh tone, and then now we're back to the sunshine. Ooh, the synth progression in the background is really fucking nice. Reminds me of, like, someone on their deathbed. Like, I'm dying. This is sad, girl. I'm leaving. Sleep now in the fire. Waiting in hell, girl, for you. You'll be here soon. It's just so creative. He's opening it up now. Facing out a bit. My name's Topher Grace, and welcome to Grace, baby. Oh, you're so bright, man. I didn't expect this. Ooh. This is great. This is fantastic. Ah! Fuck yeah! Fuck. This man really said, I'm gonna drop the hardest fucking album of all time. And death. Prop, respect to him, man. It's classy as fuck. His voice is great. Those runs at the end there, those were awesome, man. Who was gatekeeping this shit? Who was like... Don't tell anyone about Grace, man. Oh, man. That's goodbye. Oh, and it's so bittersweet, dude, because, like, all these songs are about, like, goodbye. Being gone. These cards are great, really. Layered. Really sound different from each other in the mix. Oh, of course this kid. What is that, untuned or something? Out of key? It's because you want me. Not control me. Rings? Heck yeah. This is more of the end of a relationship, though. People moving on from each other. The strings come in those knives. Damn. That one I didn't like as much as the first two, but still, his vocal performance is so great. It's layered so well. I can't give it anything but the perfect. This shit ballin'. We ballin' here now. I regret not listening to this sooner. Lilac Wine. I lost myself on a cool dead night by a strange delight. This is a cover. I like how you're stripping it back here, just letting the music take it. I haven't heard the original song, so I don't know. When I think more than I wanna think. They're soulful. You can tell he's inspired by a lot of early soul singers. A lot of probably black singers, like drink much more than I like Etta James vein a little bit. Oh, it's like a waltz. Kinda cool. But really slowed down, that's cool. You can tell he definitely feels passionate about the style of music, man. Like, he really loves to fucking listen to, and what he loves to fucking perform. like I'm like having like an out of body experience here, man. Just like floating. This music just get louder and softer too. Like they play with the actual volume of it. I find there's these big powerful moments where the volume comes up. It's kind of cool. Uh-oh. Waited for it and just let it go. That was so cool. Just the sounds are so crisp. They don't feel compressed in any way. They just expand out into this space. Every little note just feels fantastic. Man, I am really enjoying this is fantastic. Everything I'm hearing so far. I'm a boomer, guys. So real, guys. My stomach. A badass. Step on a crack, your baby mama's back. Everybody knows that. You know that shit. Oh, yeah, it's just loud. Like dragons. Dragons. Ooh! Ah! Getting grabbed? What the fuck? Where did this come from? That's nasty. I love you. Why have I not heard the song before? Man, once you hear this fucking song. No! It's just so beautifully written, like the amount of images you get from just so little here. Aggression is perfect. Oh, climbing right now, man. Yeah, don't end it there. Keep going higher. This is one of the best I've ever played. This shitty music. It's rare to get just a masterpiece dropped on top of you like this. It's just perfect in every aspect. The progression, the climaxes, the volume control, the lyrics, the imagery, the fucking rhyme schemes. Like, everything about it is solid. I know this one. It's the Shrek one. Hear the roar. I've never heard this intro on it, though. Talk to me, Buckley. Yeah, this is right where I always hear it starting, right here.
Well, I heard there was a secret chord
that David played and it pleased him though.
But you and the major lift, the baffled king composing hallelujah.
Fucking chills. Oh my god. I don't think I've ever heard this version, actually. I don't think I've heard the other versions. This is great. The instrumental is blended so well.
She tied you to her kitchen chair, and she broke your throne, and she cut your hair.
God!
And from your lips, you do
what the fuck are you doing, man?
And I've seen your flag on the marble arch. And love is not a victory march. It's a cold and it's a broken hallelujah.
His voice toned, I can't even describe it. It's angry, but like sad, but like subtle at the same time. It's like, oh, he's almost about to cry. But it's You're so fucking angry.
Remember when I moved in you, and the holy dove was moving too, and every breath we drew is hallelujah.
Fuck. It's so simple, but so good, man. It's so powerful. Oh my god. This part playing on this shit is phenomenal, too.
Not a cry.
Boy, I'm coming up again.
It's not somebody who's seen the light. It's a cold and it's a broken hallelujah. Hallelujah.
Yeah, I've never heard that verse before. I've heard other versions, but this is the fucking definitive version. God damn. Holy shit. Yeah. He's just like me. Damn, that shit go hard. That shit nutty. There's not really a lot you can say about fucking Hallelujah. It's a fucking classic. One that pulls so much fucking imagery and so much hurt, so much remorse. I think that song means something different to everyone. Honestly. Rip Jeff, rip Chris, rip Chester. This is perfect. This song, this album going perfect for perfect for perfect. We're about halfway done. Let this truck along. Lover, you should come over. Oh, you should have come. You didn't. He's done miracles on me. Oh, is that like a bagpipe or an organ or something? Like...
Looking out the door, I see the rain fall apart.
Oh, the progression of this one's great. I love this. Kind of a country influence a little bit. And that guitar, at least. Drum pattern. I put your picture away. I'm sorry. When he opens up like that, it's just... Hold on, let me feel this, dude. I'm in a plane right now. Hold on. We bug blood it up here. Oh. Oh, it's like blues even. Oh. I could give fuck all what it's about, man. Let me just feel it. Is that the first verse? Brother, that felt like a whole fucking song! Okay, no, we're in verse four, okay. I thought that was like the first verse and chorus. That's the kind of shit that the soul, like, feeds your fucking soul. When the hurt can't be raced anymore. You gotta just go relate at the end of the movie. The story's over, babe. Might be my favorite on the album, man. Oh, feels like a closer. Layering the instruments coming in here. Say, man, I don't know what to do. Love a girl, baby, bitch. You should come over, girl. Oh, fuck. That one hit. That one tickled my taint, man. It came in after the others were asleep and came into my bed and started cuddling me. Like, ooh, shit, I love that one. That's my favorite one on the album, man. I mean, Hallelujah is a classic. But that progression, oh my god. The layering, the use of the instrumentation bringing in, the organ and the piano and shit being used, that was godlike. The world had to kill this dude before he won music. It's like, this dude's too powerful. Let's put him down. Corpus Christi Carol. Oh, it's like a medieval thing. Like, I heard that. He bear her off, he bear her down, he bear her into a door. I've heard this before. The original song. This one. A weird choice for the album, but I can't say I hate it. Voice is just godlike, man. Who else can do this? Falsetto, like. It's about Christ, right? It definitely does a good job of keeping the hallelujah theme. Like he's definitely talking about God a lot on this album, the religious aspects. And, like, I think if we're staying in that tone, that was a good addition to the album. I can't say that I disagree with its placement there. You know, little jarring, sure, compared to everything else. But we probably needed a break after that last song. That last song was so good. All right, Eternal Life. Not Tool. Tool intro, man. What? What the fuck? I see why we had that little piece in the middle, man. They hit the. That piece in the middle was needed. Never mind. That sounds like fucking Billy Corgan's with Smashing Pumpkins. Racist, get the fuck out. You're fucking racist. Don't come to my show. That's a hard thing to do these days, man, to love everyone. The world don't want you to. This is against the abuse, the colonized, the corporate entity, the murderers. Fuck hate. Love where we at, baby. Be a little bit more like this guy every day. Oh no, not me. We never lost. Ridge, we ring the bell. Baby, don't hurt me. Just expect Soundgarden in that girl. Really, you would say a lot about society. Damn, he would have made a sick COVID out. Damn, this climax is great. I didn't expect that in any way, like an angry song out of there, like really fucking rock oriented, but it's great. No children allowed, god damn it. We put them down. This is what I'm saying. Compelling music under 10 minutes, baby. That's what I'm here for. Take note, swans. Back on that Tom York flow. Bars. Savannah. Somebody rap that for me real quick. Yeah. Green eyes, blue goodbyes with a head in the hands. A kiss on the lips of another. Yeah. That's cool. Don't make me that door. Got the bell. Where are we going? I gotta give it the low key. Okay. Let's take 3/4 way through the song. There'll be a explosion though. We're flying, we're built. Oh, it might be coming now, actually. Oh. I'm being surrounded by death. Like, I've never felt so crowded in a song, but so alone at the same time. Does that make sense? Like, the horn on him? Yeah, here we go. We're here. possibility of being left behind as a foreigner calling you away. Haunting you. Like, it sounds bright and cheery, but it's like a warning more than it is cheery. Deep in the sand with the ocean washing over. And just another one of those mood pieces. It's not my favorite, but I do really. We're on the final track, baby! Woo! If you're here, drop a sub. God, if you're skipping through this video, those looking for a song you want, hey, happy to have you. Drop a sub. Oh, I like how they boom, boom, none. Good clothes, really. Like, I forgot your name. Not the clothes, but I would have chose. There's a song a lot earlier I would have put as a closer, but I bet you that like doo-woppy sort of boom, 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 boom. Very retrospective, though, so maybe that's why. Oh, I love the climax. Oh, we're going to the climax. Ooh, I can get a guitar solo. Okay. Ooh. It's great. Let's see what's closer now. Totally in there. Never been through heartbreak, but I like him. I'm a sad boy, dude. That's another perfect climaxes. The fucking solos and shit. Again, the instrumentation that's added, fucking good, so fucking good, man. That was great. Take a moment, breathe for a second, man. That's it's so rare to find something so creative and so unique. It's like, it just hits in every aspect, lyrically, instrumentally, fucking the layering, the schemes, the progression of each song, just every part of it was good, great, perfect. So if I had to give this album rating out of 10, damn, girl, that's a 10. There was not a fucking ounce of fat on that. It was so lean, so perfect. It's like someone that drops you a perfect looking steak on a plate in front of you. You don't really know what to expect. You don't know this restaurant. You take a bite though. You know, this could be bigger, right? This is a pretty small steak, right? You take a bite, it's perfect. You eat every last drop of it. And it fills you up perfectly. Like it did its job. It worth every penny. That's what this album is. Every second of this I love. I loved everything about this album. I wouldn't cut any part of it. What's funny is there's a viewer of mine who I'm mutuals on Twitter with. So hey, follow me on Twitter and I'll probably call you back. But they post about their sort of music journey, the albums they're listening to and things. It's like, shit, they're kind of following the exact progression that I want to follow. So it's like, do I copy them? Do I just listen to the same albums they're listening to? Be like, ah, the things I tweet about, he seems to listen to. Ah, I was like, I already wanted to listen to him. You're out there, shout out to him. Thank you guys. Drop a sub, please. Want to get to a 1K if we can do it by the end of the year. Probably not going to happen, but we can try. Please share out. Have any suggestions, let me know. I love your face. Outro.